Hi everybody, welcome back to my channel. Thank you all for joining me. I hope you're all doing well. I've just touched something on my mug and I don't know what it was. Ooh, I don't know what that is. Anyway, hello. I'm a bit all over the place today. I have started filming this already, and then my neighbour knocked at the door and I forgot altogether where I was and what I was on about, so I've just started again. We've been doing the shopping, as I'm sure I've mentioned before, and he was just returning the shopping bags, adhering to social distancing, of course. Today is Wednesday. Hugo has just belched, so apologies if you heard that. It's feeding time, but they've not finished this morning's food. With the warm weather, they've just not been eating as much. They like to eat later on, so it's about 6 now, I think, maybe 6:30. And I normally feed them between 5 and 7-ish, so I'm going to leave it a little longer, not got my teeth in, because he's just finished his breakfast, so I don't want to like give him more than he needs, but I also don't want him to be hungry. I never know what to do. Anyway, today I had a Zoom call with Denise and Jan and a couple of other YouTubers who you may know. And it was really good fun. It was really nice to actually talk, not only talk to people and get a response, but like Denise watches me, I hope, or she might not, but I watched Denise. It was weird for us to be having a conversation, but it was really nice and I really enjoyed it. We were on a couple of hours. Unfortunately, my phone died. I knew it was dying of battery. And I thought I'd sussed it with plugging it in, but I think it was just using that much battery life that it didn't matter that it was on charge. So I got kicked out prematurely, but I did tell him I thought I was going to go. Excuse me, sorry, I'm drinking a cup of coffee. I feel like it's making me burp. Lovely. Yeah, so I had a really lovely afternoon on the Zoom call. Meeting, it wasn't really a meeting, we were very unprofessional if it was. And yeah, I'm still on my yarn busting efforts. What I want to do is to use up as much as I possibly can, and then perhaps treat myself to a bit of yarn. But I have a lot of, as you know, I don't buy yarn with projects in mind, I just buy yarn because I think, oh, pretty. But, sorry, I feel like I'm looking around loads. But that sort of doesn't always help with when it comes to actually making projects. So I have a lot of like single balls or two balls and a couple of colours that they could go together. But then I also have a lot of like random shades that don't really mix well. So I'm trying to make it work as best I can. And just really use some up, and also buying, not that I'm only going to ever buy one brand again, but I think I've said before, buying between different brands gives you different qualities. So some are rougher, some are thicker, some are thinner, some are softer, and I think that's fine, it doesn't really matter. But you know, sometimes I've got like, I've got two yarns that I think look nice together, but there's no way they'd like work up nicely together without it being lumpy, or I don't know, maybe I'm being a bit picky, but ooh, spilling coffee everywhere. Anyway, yeah, I just want to use it all up, and I think I've mentioned before, the spare bedroom will eventually have to be a spare bedroom rather than just yarn. So the blankets last week were well received by the hospital, so I made another. I don't know if I told you about that, but they sent me a picture. Well, my friend who dropped them off, who works at the hospital, he sent me a picture of the nurses holding up some of them on the ward, and it was a lovely picture. And the nurse who I'd been speaking to about making the blankets sent me another picture of it all like laid out on a bed, and it was really nice, and I'm really glad they're being used. But it did upset me a bit of, I'd like a better circumstance to be helping, if that makes sense. I don't want to be, like I've said before, I don't want this to be a channel where we discuss the coronavirus and current events. This is our escapism and a bit of relaxing time without worrying about the state of the world, hopefully. So I don't want to go on too much, but I also don't want to trivialise it by going, oh, it's a bit sad, but I was a bit sad. You know what I mean? I don't know, like I say, I don't want to keep going on about it, so I don't feel like I can express myself properly. But it made me think about more than myself a little bit, we'll say. So I've made another. This is mostly Mariner yarns. I think the light blue is Poundland Knitting Essentials. I have enough to go round. Where am I? Here. I've literally just started it. I'm gonna do a white edge and then just be done. So I've gone from white to light to mid to royal blue, then back out, then back in, and then just edged it with a couple of colours. I'm not doing anything too frilly or fancy. Just as something different. I feel like my last blankets that I sent were very frilly and fancy, and they might want a less frilly one. I have pulled this out. I have two of these. It's not showing up very well here because I've got the lamp on. Ooh, how dramatic. It's not really dark, but the sun like sets over the front of the house and I'm at the back of the house. But it's whitey cream colour with speckles or flecks of red, yellow, purple, green and blue. I have two of these. You can probably see the colours better here. That's not helpful, is it? Anyway, I have two of these. And I thought maybe I could make like a star. And maybe edge it in one of those colours. Sorry, that was a bit aggressive. But we'll see. I pulled it out and then I've gone off the idea altogether. At the weekend, I'm not sure what days are what anymore. Is that worse or better? We'll just do that a bit. Quite like the effect. Ooh, I'm glowing. Made myself jump there. Calm down. It's the coffee, it sent me jittery. At the weekend, I don't know what I did. Did some more blanket, is what I'm trying to say. It's now 20 by 20 squares. The ends are ridiculous. So it's a good lap blanket size. Whoops. But I'm going to keep going. I quite like it being square shape, but I think it probably end up being a rectangle. The ends are ridiculous. I would never suggest, if you're going to do this, try and think of like a join as you go, is all I can say, because but also I have realised that I can like connect a strip of squares without keep cutting the yarn. I've only just realised that. But I love the randomness, I love the colours, I love that I'm using up scraps, even the smallest of scraps. Yeah, I love it so much. I probably will love it that much that I won't want to use it. Because the dog claws get into things. So that is 20 by 20 squares and it's gone back into time out for a bit. I get it out for a little bit and make a few squares and sew in a few ends and then I put it away. I have some squares made up with the ends like of the square rather than joining that need sewing. And I have a few scraps that I could make squares, but this blanket that I'm making, this one, is all blues. And then the blanket that I made, I think it was like at the start of lockdown, that's a bit much, at the start of lockdown, which was going to be, well, it's going to be for Kirk's stepdad, we'll call him, for want of a better word. That's blues and neutrals. So I am think this is taking me a really long time to say that I don't want to make too much with just those scraps, because I'm going to have like a blue section, and I really want it to be like a spreading of colours. A spreading, that sounded awful. Yes, so like, I don't know if I talk, because I haven't recorded this twice now, well, three times, because I also like come and go, hi, what are we doing? We're sorting out yarn at the weekend, trying to just pare it down, get it all onto one shelf, and I came across this. Well, I didn't come across it, I knew it was there, it didn't surprise me. So this is my giant hook project. I don't know what the official term is, or if I was following a cow. I think I don't like it anymore. So if I remember correctly, I used 12 balls of yarn, six colours, so two of each. Oh, there's a nail file attached to it, fabulous. It was, yeah, so there's two of each. There's a blue, a nude colour. If I hold it sort of against this wall, you can sort of see a nude colour, a white, like a mid grey, excuse me, like a quite a nice yellow actually, sunshine-ish yellow, and a grey, which has sparkles in it. Can you see that's the grey there? So I had two of each of these, and I wound it all up. All of the yarns were Mariner, except for the Gold Sparkle, which is Hobbycraft. Gold Sparkle, Grey Sparkle, Hobbycraft Baby Sparkle yarn is so soft. So there are 12 balls of yarn in this and this, and I just don't like it. And I don't like working with that stupid hook. There's loads of nail files in there. What is happening? They are nail files, they're not lollipop sticks. Why? So I have that. And then I've gotten to this stage, and I just don't like it. I've tried it a few ways. I've tried it making it like granny squares, and I've tried doing it backwards and forwards, and I just don't like it. I think for me, I need to hold more yarn together than just six. I feel like it's too thin. I don't even like how the colours sort of look together. Like if I was going to use a smaller hook, I like the colours individually, and I think it's a good colour palette when it looks like this. Like it's sort of like seaside theme, it reminds me of like sun, sea, sand, sparkly grey cloud. But I just don't like how it looks. So it's really soft and it's really light, but it's already got little pulls in it, like there, look. I feel really snotty, like I'm and there. And this is awful to work with. It's so light, but it's so big. And I'm normally crochet like I'm holding a pencil, not a weapon. So I think, I feel like none of my projects ever come into fruition. I think what I'm going to do somehow is pull it all back and disassemble the giant yarn ball. Because as well as I'm using it, like as I'm crocheting with it, the problem I'm finding is that the strands are not sort of staying, like I've not got the same tension on each individual strand. So you'll be working on it, and one colour will like you'll have more, like it'll go loose like that as you're doing it. And so in some bits I've tried like chopping it, like here, oh, I've just lost it there. Like I've tried chopping it and leaving a tail to sew in, but the fabric is that loose that where am I going to hide it? And I've tried just persevering, and it's just driving me mad. And I really wanted these colours to be a blanket for my Auntie Kerry. She really likes yellow and blue and grey and the rest of the colours I presume she will like. And once we saw a blanket while we were in IKEA, back in the days when we were allowed to go to IKEA, and it was just a simple, it looked like it might be knitted, I don't know what the stitch was, but it was just a simple backwards and forwards stitch. You probably could get that effect with like the moss stitch or something. It was probably knitted, like I say, on a machine because it was at IKEA, so I don't think they're gonna be selling crocheted blankets in IKEA for, I think it was like £15. And she was like, oh, and I really like that, and she never bought it. And in my head, I've had it for probably, it's probably been a couple of years now. What, how long has this been sat around? That, oh, I should make her a blanket like that and put a bit of blue in it. And haven't. So I'm thinking I'm gonna pull it all back. I'm not envisioning that that will go very well, and it might end up with lots of little balls, but I also have like the grey sparkle. I have two of the grey, but I also have a single white upstairs, which is the Hobbycraft really soft baby yarn with a white shimmer in it. I was going to call it a sprinkle. There's a bird cuckooing outside, I don't know the correct term, laughing at me. I hope it's not distracting. Because it's distracting me. Yeah, so I'm envisioning that it's going to end up being lots of like little balls of yarn, and I perhaps won't successfully do a backwards and forwards blanket if that is the case, but maybe I could do granny squares. You know how much I love a granny square, and I get granny squares done, that's the point. I am a faffer, we all know I'm a faffer. I'm wielding my weapon at you. Stupid thing. 20. I don't know what, it's 20. Yeah, so I think I'm gonna do that. I have the star I could make. I've still got the blue one to, the blue blanket to put the ends in and do an edge on it. There's plenty of other things I could do. I really wanna make myself like a garment, but I'm just scared. I'm not scared, I am unmotivated to find a pattern is what I am. I just want to know how to do it. But I think this might be getting deconstructed. Sorry, I'm a bit. Yeah, so let me know what you think. I'm probably gonna do it anyway. And like I say, I've got a couple of other single balls of yarn that could go into it and have like a obviously it'd be a really big blanket. But it'd be like a bit like the same colour palette, so I've got like a slightly different yellow, like a paler yellow that could go in it, and maybe a bit of a darker grey, just to give a variation of colours and to use more yarn, and that could be a good project. I don't know, tell me what you think. I think that's what I'm gonna do. I did try talking to Kirk about it and it was just like glazed over expression, like, what do you mean you crochet? What is this madness? Like he doesn't know what I'm on about. Anyway, it's been 18 minutes of me rambling on. My coffee has gone cold. The metallic mug, the metallic mug has not kept it warm. Thank you, Denise, for setting up our Zoom call. I feel like I've been looking all around today. I hope I'm not giving like creepy eyes off. Thank you, Denise, for organising the Zoom call. I really enjoyed it. I look forward to doing it again soon, hopefully. Hugo's like digging a blanket. This is why I can't have crocheted blankets downstairs, because the dogs think that they're theirs. Yes, we're all well, we're all safe. Looking forward to the weekend. It's bank holiday on Friday. On Friday, what? So on Friday, why do I keep saying that? We're having a Zoom quiz with my, now whacking things with the weapon hook. I'm having a Zoom quiz with my brothers and Kirk and my brother's partners. And either Friday or Saturday, myself and Kirk are getting a disposable barbecue and cooking our food on the back garden instead of in the kitchen where it's easier to do it. And we'll probably video call his mum or his sister. We've been doing that most weekends because we tend to get together at weekends quite regularly. Even like just for a cup of coffee on a Saturday morning at his mum's house. And obviously we can't do that at the moment. So we'll probably video call them at some point. And the weather's going to be nice, so we'll probably paint the deck in. It's like Kirk's life's work, he's painting that deck in. He does it every year. Every year he has like an epiphany of like, oh, we could do it this way. This year we're having a border of dark around the edge and clear in the middle, and I'm just leaving him to it. I've asked too many questions. I've got too many weird responses about like the science of decking oil that I don't care anymore. He can do what he wants. I'll just paint the bench where I don't have to crawl around on my hands and knees and then get stuck because I've been doing it for hours. Anyway, like I said, I'm gonna go. That was 4 minutes ago. Sorry, I'm a bit woo. Too much coffee and too few friends with me. Yeah, thank you all for watching. I hope you're all well and safe and enjoy the bank holiday weekend. Please stay safe. Please only go out if you absolutely need to. We'll get there. Love you all and I'll see you all next week. And oh, it's not that interesting, so I wish I'd not said it now, but I went oh, so it seems like it's interesting. I've learnt how to do my own thumbnails on these videos. So some past videos have got different thumbnails rather than me like pulling awful faces. This one might have an awful face on it. If you got to the end of the video, please comment. Dead plant. Nearly dead plant. It's a bit morbid. Comment plant. And thank you all for watching. I'm really going to go now and perhaps not drink this coffee because I don't think I need it. Thank you all for watching. See you all soon. The dogs are about to fall out. Goodbye.